We're here with the all-new BMW iX2. Now, it is the sport variant, or more of the fastback variant, of the BMW iX1 that we reviewed earlier in the year. In terms of specs, not much is different. So this vehicle has a 66.5 kilowatt hour battery, and the range is roughly good for about 449 kilometers, or roughly about 280 miles. Now, what we have here is really sort of that signature treatment of BMW, where we've got the kidney grills here as well as the closed off grills because it is an electric vehicle. And then here we've got the intake for battery cooling. A nice aggressive look. BMW is beginning with its new sort of treatment right here, where it's got sort of the indented sort of hood crease with the BMW roundel. And a nice aggressive look, but not that much of a departure from the iX1. And then if we come around here, we've got these nice LED headlights, and they've got the blue accents for that indication that it is an electrified vehicle. If we come around to the side, here you can see we've got the charging port right here, and this is using the CCS connector. We know for Japan that the iX line uses a dual connector system for the CHAdeMO standard. For those who are fans of iX1 and iX2, or owners, there is a unique feature on iX2 and iX1 that's specific to Japan, and that is a second charging port here. And this right here is for the CHAdeMO connector. The CHAdeMO connector is the predominant charging standard in Japan, and BMW has adapted its electric line of vehicles, including i4 and its iX line of vehicles, with CHAdeMO, a second CHAdeMO charging port for the Japanese market. In terms of charging capabilities, BMW iX2 is pretty much identical to its BMW iX counterpart. This vehicle can charge from 10 to 80% in under 30 minutes with DC fast charging, which is identical to its BMW iX1 counterpart. If you'd like to know more about the capabilities of both vehicles in terms of charging, check out our video on BMW iX1. So as you can see, BMW, because it's using a shared architecture with its petrol vehicles, that there is no frunk. So effectively, the electronic major systems are housed under the hood. Here we've got sort of the tires right here, and these are sitting on 20-inch rubber 245 series, and you've got that nice BMW M caliper in there for that sporty look. If we step away from the vehicle, you can see sort of kind of nice flat surface right here with a little bit of a crease, and as we come along to the roof line right here, it gets into that fastback look and that sort of strong shoulder to give it its sort of sporty intentions. Coming around to the back, now this is where it's really interesting. We've got sort of that very sort of sporty look to it right here with these sort of angular geometric lights right here. And then the bumper treatment is clearly different from the iX1. Even though the iX2 does have sort of sporty looks, there is some fakery going on here with the diffuser. You have the piano black finish, but it is more for cosmetic purposes than it is for actual functional purposes. So what do you think about this rear design on the BMW iX2? Do you like it, or is it something that you could leave alone? So overall, a very sort of interesting design to distinguish it from the iX1, with more sort of the lower slung roof line. So you might be asking yourself, is it really different than the iX1 in terms of proportions? And the answer is no. The two vehicles share nearly identical proportions, which is a little bit deceiving. BMW has some visual trickery going on with the iX2, but in terms of the overall width, length, and height, it is nearly identical to the iX1, save for a few dozen millimeters, which really, again, might make the difference in terms of cargo, where the BMW iX1 is a little bit taller, but overall, these are nearly identical vehicles. It's just a matter of taste. Do you want more of the conventional SUV look with iX1, or do you want more of the sporty look with iX2? Let us know what you think. Leave your comments in the comment section below. Also, if you have any questions, leave those in the comment section below as well. So it's been some time since we reviewed the BMW iX1, so we don't remember everything. What I can tell you is iX1 had a nice sort of sporty cockpit feel for what it was as an SUV. This has sort of a similar type of feel as well. I'm lowering the seat and I'm really going to push it forward, and you do get sort of, again, that real sort of cockpit feel, sport sedan feel. My initial impression just at looking at iX2, the nose feels a bit higher on this car than it does with iX1, and I don't know why that is. So I'm raising my seat and now I can see over the hood pretty well, but there's a slight bulge on the hood. So that could be something that really differentiates the two cars. Based on my impressions, I would say I prefer the feel of the iX1. It just seems like I have a better sense of where the nose is when the car is in my preferred seating position. And I'm going to bring this down as well, bring the tilt wheel down, and this would be my preferred position. And I would say the iX1 definitely feels more comfortable or more to my liking. But again, for someone who's driving this type of vehicle, that might not be a major concern. I'm raising my seat and you can get a very good view, I mean stellar view, of the nose of this car from this position right here. So again, it's all a matter of preference, but for me, I would go with the iX1. I just felt like it had more of that true sort of sports sedan feel. I don't know why. We don't have an iX1 here to compare it against, but still all in all very nice. In this one, what we notice is different in iX2 versus iX1, the wireless charging pad here is different than iX1. That's very interesting. There are two prominent USB-C ports right here, very visible and easy to see. And you've got this sort of floating sort of console right here with the drive controls. And interestingly, BMW has placed them to the left so that the driver doesn't accidentally touch them. And then you've got the volume controls as well. And then here we've got a sub-storage area also. And yes, for putting things like smartphones or keys or your wallet, that's a nice feature as well. The cup holders, again. We've talked about the BMW infotainment display. There's really nothing new here in terms of what I can see. And overall, this interior, it is more or less identical to BMW iX1. The seats are quite comfortable and supportive in typical BMW fashion. So nothing new to report there. Really, the context of this video is just to show the differences between BMW iX1 and iX2, as well as introduce this vehicle. And it is typical BMW. You know what you're gonna get. No gimmicks here, and that's not a bad thing. Now we've got the panoramic moonroof right here. This one's smaller than iX1, at least from what I recall in this video. And so yeah, this does seem a good bit smaller. And the reason being, again, that fast back profile on the BMW iX2 versus the iX1, which is more of a conventional flat roof. The consequence of that in iX2 is that you get a smaller panoramic moonroof in this vehicle here. We're gonna hop into the back of BMW iX2, and here we go. All right. So again, for taller passengers, there is sufficient headroom, but it might feel a little bit sort of, in some ways, a little tight. Maybe if you have claustrophobia, it might not be the most comfortable, because there is definitely sort of a, you know, fairly shallow sort of space between the top of a taller passenger's head and the roof line. The seats are quite comfortable. Maybe again, on a long trip, the bench seems a little bit short, so it might not be the most comfortable for taller passengers. And so yeah, that's again a personal preference. There's a nice storage at the bottom of the iX2 rear console. So if someone needs to charge their phone and there happens to be a short cable, it's not a bad place to put one's phone away. Or if you just want to put your phone down for a while, that's a good place to park it in the BMW iX2. There's a nice footwell right here to put your feet under, and the sort of under thigh support is okay in this car. One of the things too, the back seat really doesn't feel like it has that great of a support. It feels a bit flat right here. So again, not the type of vehicle that you'd want to take on a long road trip with taller passengers, but for small families or someone who just wants a sporty compact SUV and in EV form, this works well. You've got the rear camera right here and the cleaner, and then this roundel right here opens the rear trunk compartment or boot. Nice trunk space in the BMW iX2. You can get a couple of medium-sized suitcases or three small suitcases in here. There's a little pocket for storage and then a cargo net as well. I'm gonna lift up the underfloor, and you've got a shallow area here, and that would be for EV charging cables or for shallow storage overall. Here is another little pocket as well for some additional storage. That might actually be really ideal for EV charging cables, so that this area here can be used for some sort of shallow type of storage. In terms of cargo capacity, the BMW iX2 has a boot capacity of 525 liters. Now, with the seats folded down, that reaches a maximum of 1,400 liters. Interestingly, its BMW iX1 counterpart has a boot capacity of 490 liters, and with the seats folded down in that vehicle, reaches upwards of 1,500 liters. It's very interesting that this car, with its lower roof profile, has a larger boot capacity, but obviously with the taller roof profile of the BMW iX1, that is able to reach a larger cargo capacity with the seats folded down. So very interesting. I don't know if that's a result of sort of redesign in terms of the architecture of BMW iX2, which gives it more boot capacity than iX1, or if it is improvements in BMW's battery technology that's allowed them to achieve more cargo space inside BMW iX2 versus its iX1 sibling.